Dear students, in this video lecture, we will see the differences between the signal transduction and the quorum sensing. Already we have seen a lot of points related to signal transduction, how it is happening, what is its pathway, what is mean by receptor, what is mean by signal molecules, how they are attaching to receptor, and then how the signal has been transmitted there inside the cell, and finally how a response has been created there through the expression of the genome. The quorum sensing also, we have already seen a few points there through some other videos, such as a density dependent sensing of the organisms that have been present there. Now we look at the definition there for the signal transduction. Signal transduction is also called as a cell signaling process, in which transmission of molecular signals from an eukaryotic cell exterior to its interior with the help of ligand and receptor protein. So that is a point we have already narrated. Signal transduction pathways on final point will produce a cellular response, that is, as certain chemical changes, that is expression of certain genes. So this is the one that have been depicted there in this diagram also. So this diagram shows the cell signaling. It shows how a signal molecule is getting attached there to the receptor. Then that particular signal has been transmitted inside and through inside the cell, and finally a gene expression is taking place. So this is the signal transduction. Now we look at into the quorum sensing. Quorum sensing is the regulation of gene expression in prokaryote in response to fluctuations there in the cell population density. Quorum sensing in bacteria produce and release certain chemical molecules called as the autoinducers. An example for autoinducer is acyl homoserine lactone. As a result of the cell density, its concentration increases. The detection of a minimum threshold stimulatory concentration of an autoinducer can able to alter the expression of genes inside the bacterial cell. So that is the one effected through quorum sensing. So before going into quorum sensing, again some more explanation related or recollection of the signal transduction or cell signaling that happens in the eukaryotic organisms. So a signal molecule is getting attached there to a receptor, which is further taken up into the cell through various second messengers or signal relay pathways, and finally the gene is getting activated with certain chemical responses. So that is the total process of the signal transduction or cell signaling or cell to cell communication. This is a common thing in eukaryotes. Here the ligand molecule or signal is involved, receptor, a kind of protein that have been present there in the surface of the cell membrane or which is present in the interior, has been involved as a molecule which transmits a signal to the interior of the cell. And finally, the information, the signal is converted to a cellular response. That is the point I have told. It's a chemical change that have been effected through the expression of the gene or the DNA. Now we look at the quorum sensing in bacteria. So as I already told, quorum sensing is a mechanism by which bacteria produces an autoinducer molecule, which when reaches a particular threshold, that particular autoinducer is taken inside the bacteria and which can able to trigger a varied responses there. So that is the one it has been explained there in this diagram. You can able to see a lot of autoinducer molecule, that is acyl homoserine lactone, is being excreted or sent out of the cell or exported out of the cell. You can look at the arrow here, which shows that AHL molecule has been sent out or excreted out of the cell. So this thing as reaching a particular threshold concentration. When a particular threshold is reached, say for example 10 nanomolar concentration, approximately the cell density that have been present there in that location will be around 10 power 10 to 10 power 12 cells. That is a particular threshold of cells and the autoinducer molecule has been gathered in that particular environment. This makes the autoinducer molecule to move inside or taken up inside the cell, which triggers a cellular response. So that is the total mechanism of quorum sensing there in the bacteria. So here we look at some point related to the quorum sensing. What is the reasons? It is coordinate behavior of the cells. Here the whole mechanism is not mediated by a single cell, whereas the coordination of several cells result there in a process to get initiated. Say it is a coordinate behavior and it is the adaptation of the cell to that particular environment. What are the factors that guiding the quorum sensing includes? Ambient temperature, then a presence of host factors, then nutrient availability. So these are all important for the process to get initiated. What are all the final chemical responses or gene expression that could be triggered by the operation of this quorum sensing includes motility of the cells. In a simpler cells, cells may start motile or start moving when a enough threshold concentration of bacteria are being present in that locality, or the genes that are required for the motility will triggered only when a particular numbers of cells are being present in that locality. That is the adaptation, coordinative behavior or social behavior of the single celled organism to be present together. Then excretion of exoenzymes, exopolysaccharides, surfactant production, antibiotic production for colonizing in a locality, these are all mediated through quorum sensing. That is the reason why in the field of medical microbiology, they are trying to find certain compound that can able to inhibit the quorum sensing process, so that the bacteria may not able to colonize on a particular region. By quenching the quorum also, you can able to control the spread of bacteria in a particular organ or in the human system. Again, the last point is quorum sensing are related there with the genetic material exchanges between the organisms. That is also even possible only during the quorum sensing. What is its importance? It's a first finding there in the history of prokaryotic organism, which states that small molecules, that is acyl homoserine lactone or autoinducers, are playing a major role there in the cell to coordinate their behavior, better adapt to a condition. Say in Tamil, I want to say a few points here. You may know about the legume plants. Legume plants பாத்தீங்கனா பயறு வகை பயிர்கள் அப்படினு சொல்லிட்டு சொல்வாங்க. பயறு வகை பயிர்கள்னா அந்த பயிர்கள் என்னன்னு பாத்தீங்கனா அவரை, உளுந்து, நிலக்கடலை, வேர்க்கடலை, இதையெல்லாம் பாத்தீங்கனா பயறு வகை பயிர்கள் அப்படினு சொல்வாங்க. இந்த பயிர்கள்ல பாத்தீங்கனா இந்த மாதிரி ஒரு வேர் முடிச்சு இருக்கும். இந்த வேர் முடிச்சுல பாத்தீங்கனா நைட்ரஜனை கிரகிக்கிற ரைசோபியன்ற நுண்ணுயிரி வந்து வாழ்ந்துட்டு இருக்கும். இந்த நுண்ணுயிரி எப்படி இந்த வேர் பகுதியில வந்து சேருதுன்றதுக்கும் குவாரம் சென்சிக்கும் நிறைய சம்பந்தம் இருக்குது. அது என்ன என்பதை இந்த படத்தின் மூலமா நம்ம பார்க்கலாம். இது ஒரு பயிர் வகை பயிர்னு நினைச்சிங்களேன், ஒரு உளுந்து இல்ல ஒரு நிலக்கடலை அல்லது வேர்க்கடலை அப்படின்னு பாத்தீங்கன்னா அந்த இடத்துல வளர்ந்துருக்குது. அதோடைய வேர்ல பாத்தீங்கன்னா வேர் முடிச்சுகள் உருவாகுது, அதுதான் நாடுலேஷன் அப்படின்னு சொல்லிட்டு சொல்லுவாங்க. முதல்ல இந்த வேர் முடிச்சுகள்லாம் உருவாகிறதுக்கு முன்னாடி இந்த வேர் முடிச்சுகளை யார் உருவாக்குறாங்க அப்படின்னா அது ரைசோபியத்தால தான் உருவாகுது. ரைசோபியம் என்பது இந்த மண்ணுல இதோடைய வேர் பகுதிகளில் இருக்கும். எட்ட எட்ட ஒரு ஒரு ரைசோபியம் செல்ஸ் பாத்தீங்கன்னா இருக்கும். இவை எல்லாம் ஒன்னா ஒரு இடத்துல சேரத்துக்கு கண்டிப்பா குவாரம் சென்சிங் என்ற மெக்கானிசம் வந்து ரொம்பவும் ஹெல்ப்ஃபுல்லா இருக்கு. ஹீமோடாக்சிஸ்னா ஒரு கெமிக்கலை நோக்கி அந்த செல்ஸ் எல்லாம் மூவ் பண்றது. இந்த செடியை பாத்தீங்கன்னா அது அதோடைய வேர் பகுதியில இருந்து நிறைய கெமிக்கல்ஸ் செக்ரேட் பண்ணும். அந்த கெமிக்கல்ஸை நோக்கி இந்த ரைசோபியம் எல்லாம் மூவ் ஆகும். ஆனா இந்த இடத்துல அந்த ரைசோபியம் எல்லாம் முதல்ல வந்து சேரத்துக்கு ரொம்ப ஹெல்ப்ஃபுல்லா இருக்கிற ப்ராசஸ் என்னன்னு பாத்தீங்கன்னா குவாரம் சென்சிங். அந்த குவாரம் சென்சிங் வழியா தான் அவைகள் அந்த வேர்கிட்ட வரும். அதுக்கப்புறம் அது வேருக்குள்ளாருக்க போய் வேர் முடிச்சிகளை ஏற்படுத்தும்.